lot of retail brands, that is shops like Max, Retail Trend, Reliance Trends. These shops, you can see, they will have a promotional activity where they will say, if you get one piece, it is 299. If you get two pieces, 100 rupees less in your total amount. So this also is an innovation. So here, innovation need not be a new product, a new design, or new concepts. You can be innovative in any ways. Either it can be in marketing, it can be in manufacturing, or it can be in your product design. What is creativity? So creative thinking enables the individual to look at things from all different angles to create something new. So innovation is a process, whereas creativity is a thinking where you can an individual can think in 360 degrees, or we can say nowadays 720 degrees. That is why I've given creativity happens in your head. So when we say creativity, it is your brain which creates new things. Whereas innovation, it happens in the world. So when your brain thinks differently, you're able to get new ideas. When you process that new ideas and when you're able to commercialize that new ideas, that becomes an innovation where it does that innovation will be marketed in the world. It is nothing but innovation happens in the world is whatever idea that blings or brightens in your head, automatically you try to convert that ideas into business models, and the business models will be displayed in the world by the name innovation. So this is the two words which is correlated for any success of any business in the world. So you might have heard about the word startups. Now, the entrepreneur development or entrepreneur has been replaced by the word startups. So startups is nothing but a small new business. We can say that it is a newborn business or a newborn business which is just a 1 year old, which is struggling in the market. And there are lot of government policies, government aids, and there are lot of investors who try to help them and make them come out. So how the small born babies, how they can go and shine, grow and shine in the world is by having new innovative ideas. And unless otherwise you're innovative and you're creative, nowadays in this competitive world, we cannot shine at all. That is why we say that this INC, why we talk about INC, why this INC is important. You may get a question, is it now without this INC cannot we succeed in the business? Can you give any business as an example which is not innovative or creative is more than 100 years in the business? No. You cannot identify even a single business where they have not used this I or C to scale up their business. Any success business, any business which is more than 20 years, 25 years, it might have reached 100, 150 years. If you go and see the success story behind that, surely this I or the C contribution will be more, without which you cannot succeed in the business. Why we need this INC? These are the three reasons why we talk about this INC frequently. One is business growth. So if you want to grow your business, if your business has to be reached heights, or if your business has to be established throughout the global, then you should be innovative. You should be creative. How I can be creative or how I can be innovative? You just go search for the new ideas, compare with your competitors, find it out what is they are lacking, what new things you can give, what new ideas you can put into your business growth. The business growth, when we talk about business growth, again, it is something related with the society, related with the customers, related with the suppliers, where we call it as the stakeholders. So all stakeholders has to be satisfied with your innovative ideas. It is not so easy to balance all the stakeholders, because your supplier will be in the motive of earning profit, your customer will be seeking for the goods at a cheaper price, the society may demand a product which is eco-friendly. So there are a lot of challenges that you have to face and you have to overcome to make your business grow. So to face these challenges, you should have certain tactics, and you should be innovative enough, creative enough to find solutions. See, if your supplier is not ready to supply you with a product which is at a cheaper rate, again you have a challenge to face where you cannot give your customer at a cheaper price. And another thing is, nowadays we talk a lot about eco-friendly products, where you have to invest in an amount where, so that has, so also to be balanced. So when we talk about business growth, all this has to be taken into consideration. Here, let me give an example. If you take a dairy milk, most of us, everyone might have tasted the dairy milk. See, before 10 years, if you see the dairy milk, which is available at present for rupees 5, the thickness of the dairy milk was very thick. Now, day by day, it reduced, and you can see the dairy milk is very thin for the same 5 rupees. For last 10 years, everybody know, even an illiterate knows, that the cost of production has increased. All the prices of the products has increased. But till date, how the dairy milk is able to give the same product at rupees 5? See here, even there is a concept called as just noticeable difference, where they have used that concept whereby they are innovative too. So how my cost of production has increased, but I cannot increase the price of the product. I have to satisfy my target customers. So what is the way? So slowly they reduced the thickness of the dairy milk, the product, the bar of the dairy milk, and they just marketed for the same price. So these are some of the innovative ideas that the business you have to think on. Because as I said, you have to satisfy all your stakeholders. Unless otherwise, you cannot grow your business. So to satisfy my customers, I should see that all has to be satisfied at the same time. My business also has to grow. So what ideas I can put in without disturbing the entire team of my business? So there again, the I or C contribution will be there. And the second thing why we need I or C is to benchmark the competitors. As I said, once the market was opened, the global market, because before globalization, or normally we used to say in our terms, LPG, that is liberalization, privatization, and globalization. Before the globalization concept was introduced, all the countries, they had their own borders and they were trading inside their borders. Whereas after globalization, the entire globe is under one roof. So you can, and the technological development also had made the availability of the product throughout the country. So there are much competitions, and there are companies from the developed countries who come and compete with us. And to face the competition and to benchmark. Benchmarking is nothing but be unique. To give a unique product or a unique design or whatever it is. Something uniqueness you have to provide to your target customers. To be unique, to be benchmarked with your competitors. Again, you should be innovative or you should be creative. Unless otherwise you're innovative or unique, uniqueness can be shown only through innovation. So to benchmark with your competitors, again, you need I or C. And then third one is explore technology. So here you have to explore. As we all know, after this technological development, there are lots and lots of changes that has happened in the business. It has an unimaginable changes have been brought inside the business after exploring the technology. The best example which I can give is the online classes. We never thought, have you ever imagined that there will be a life like this, which we have crossed for the last 2 years? No, nobody imagined that. And we have never thought that this type of classes will be possible. But the technology made it. During pandemic, the exploration of technology in the education field has played an enormous role. And in all the fields of business, I can say in all the areas of business, the technology has turned the business into the next level. I just give you an example, how this technology has disruption of this technology in the various areas. So this particular slide, it talks about disruption in the taxi service. Have we never imagined that we can get a taxi at our footstep just by sitting at the home, just opening an app, you can book a taxi and it will be available at any place, wherever it is. Even if you are in the any remote area, now it is easy for us to access the taxi services. So how was it possible? It was through the technological development it has made. So before, if you want to book a taxi, we have to go to a taxi stand, search for a taxi stand, then book a driver, negotiate with them for the rates and other things. Then only we'll get a taxi, where we have to cross lot of hurdles. But now it is not. Technology has made us to book a taxi sitting at our home. Same way, again, groceries. So if previously, if you want to buy any groceries, you have to go visit a departmental store or a general store, which is in our nearby our street. We have to pick, and we have to travel a lot. Whereas now it is not, it is at your mobile phone, where you can just sit, you can search in your mobile phone, you can choose the product at your budget, and you can place an order where they will come and deliver the groceries at your. See the areas where all the technology has changed, and this is all the areas where the innovations are important. Disruptions in books, again, the technology has not left any area. It has covered everything from A to Z. So even books nowadays, it's available. You have a Kindle, you have an N number of e-library accesses, websites where you can go read, and you have separate links for the authors. Each and every authors, you can just choose from them your favorite authors, your favorite books, your favorite titles, your favorite subjects. So all this is possible because of technology. Even hotel industries. Now you can just sit at your home, book your train ticket along with your book. Train tickets, you can book your cab, book your rooms, everything. So just checking in the flight or in a train, just reaching the station, Ole gives you everything. Everything is possible in one app. In shopping pattern, as those new generations, you people have explored yourself to this shopping. So nowadays, we need not go get to shop, step into different shops to get the dress materials. It is online shops are there, where you can just enter into their app and they give you lot of promotional activities, and you can choose your dresses from the online. So these are the areas where the technology has explored and made, has changed the entire business models. All this are the examples of, again, when it comes to Olay, I'll just give you a how this Olay concept came into exist. And that is the Olay founder, he was traveling from one place to another. He was traveling and he hired a taxi to travel from Bangalore to his native place. In the mid of the, so everything he finalized with the taxi driver, what is the rate, how many hour it takes, everything was finalized, and at last happily he started the journey. In the mid of the travel, there came an argument between the driver and the customer, and the argument went into a fight, and at last the driver just dropped the customer in mid of the street and he went away. So at that point of time, he had an idea. The idea sparked in him, what is the solution for this? It is not myself. I'm not the only customer who's finding this type of difficulty while booking a hiring a taxi or booking a taxi. So what is the solution for this problem? So there sparked an idea of this Uber Ole, where he went, sat with the friends, talked, discussed, and he explored the business. So the technology and the technology side, again, the idea alone cannot be brought into business. You have to combine the technology also. So here, what I want to say to you is, without technology, nothing is possible nowadays. You have to have the technology with you, with which you can explore yourself to the next end of the business. So this is the reason why we need INC. Without INC, nothing is possible. So let us see what is innovation is. So when we talk about innovation, there are three I's which plays a major role in getting innovative ideas inside the business. So it is the idea, implementation, and the impact. So you have to get, first you should get an idea. As I said, for example, Ole, how he got an idea. So when he was traveling, he faced a problem. So that problem, so he was trying to find a solution for that problem, where he got an idea of a Ole. And you can you people know that it is a zero investment business, because Ole is not owning a single taxi of its own. Everything is outsourced. Everything. See, the taxi is outsourced, the maintenance of the app is outsourced, everything is outsourced, with this which is possible only by technology. So the idea, the first thing is you should have an idea. That idea you have to develop, and it has to be implemented. So if you have an idea, you should know to convert that idea into business concepts. So for converting the ideas into the business concepts, you should have a team of members. With the help of that, you can convert your ideas into business models, and that business models, then you can implement it. That is, you can commercialize your ideas. Then you can go have a impact of an idea. So here, let me give an example of Zomato. How the Zomato, what, how they got an idea of starting a online, because we never imagined that we will get, we can sit at home and order a food. Food will be they available at our doorstep just by clicking the apps. But it was made possible by Swiggy, Zomato, and other things. So let us take an example of a Zomato. How this food company Zomato was able to explore its business. So as everyone know, food is the premium or primary thing of any person in the world, whoever it is, wherever, in whichever country they live. Without food, nothing is possible, and most of us are, we are crazed towards the food. So many people who were there, who used to wait for a longer period, longer time, and for getting a taste the varieties of cuisines that is available throughout the world. See, imagine, take for example, if you want to go have your food at a very famous restaurant, at least we have to wait for an half an hour in the busy hours. We have to stand in queues, we have to stand behind the tables in the restaurants, wait for a longer time to get the food served. So the same problem was faced by the person when he was working in a IIT. So here it is the Deepender Goyal and Pankaj. They were the alumni of IIT Delhi. So the founder of Zomato's are the alumni of IIT Delhi, and they were, after completing their degree, they got placed in a company in New Delhi. So in their office, they came across many people waiting for a long time just to acquire a menu card. Just to get a menu card itself, they have to wait for a longer time in their office canteen. After choosing from the menu card, they have to place order and they have to wait for a longer hour to get their meals or the breakfast or dinner or a snacks to be done. So these two guys, they were just observing what is happening in their office room. Then they came, then what they did is they just converted the hard copy of the menu card into a soft copy, as they are technologically strong. So by using their, so there came an idea why, see, for picking a menu, an item from a menu card itself take a half an hour to 1 hour. So what they got an idea is, why can't we convert this hard copy into a soft copy, and why can't we mail or WhatsApp to all the members in the office, so that whenever they feel like eating something, just by opening their mobile phones, they can just see the menu cards and they can order. So see where the idea was parked. It was in the canteen of their office. So this slowly they built up. So this menu card, the soft copies of the menu card was uploaded in the web. So first they uploaded in their websites, and thereon slowly they started the process. So this is the origin where they started with the Zomato. Slowly they started, extended their activities. So from Delhi, they slowly extended. Now they have reached throughout the world. So the we can say that the idea can spark at any time, at any place. But you should know to commercialize the idea and implement it. So here, when it comes to Zomato, the idea was caught in a canteen. That idea was implemented by these people, converting the hard copy into the soft copy, uploading it on the website. Slowly they started their business in New Delhi, then slowly they came down. So they started spreading their business in the north side. And what is the impact? When you're implementing, another challenge that normally you face is the funding. Because when you are stick on with the technologies, when you depend on technologies, the investment will be huge. So again, so in the implementation process, you have to take care of that also. So here, when it comes to Zomato, they were, since their app and they got this idea, they just discussed with the relatives, their friend circles, and there was a person who came forward for funding because he was impressed with the idea. So he started funding, and slowly the business started growing, and now there are a lot of people who's ready to purchase the share of Zomato. So this is how the idea will be converted into implementation and the impact. Now everyone are seeing the impact of the, that is the success of the business, how these people are able to succeed in the business. So this particular matrix, it helps you to identify the innovation and the how the product and the problem has to be matched, and how the, if it is an existing, how you can do it, if it is a new startups, how you can go with. So this matrix, it talks about the new and old idea, product or process, or the usage of the problem. So let us first take the category one, where your problem is old, the usage of the product is old, but the product or the process is new. So new solution to an old problem. So the problem is existing, it is recurring in the society, but you try to find new solutions for the existing problem. So that is what is the first category of here. And the second one is second category, both are old and there is no innovation at all. So the products or the companies which fall under this category, they will not be there in the business for a longer period of time. If there is no innovation, then surely they will fail and they will be thrown out of the market. And the third category is both is new. The product process is also new. The usage and the problem is also new. So it is mostly entirely a new innovative idea that is there. So new product that leads to new opportunities. Here just I want to tell you, you people should know to differentiate between the invention and innovation. Invention is entirely a new concept that is new. So innovations are coming out from inventions. More 90% of the products that is available in the market is an innovation. I'll give you an example. Mobile phone is an invention. But after that, everything that happened in the mobile phone is an innovation. So invention is just a button, mobile phone. Now it has, after that, whatever changes, touch screen and other apps and lots of usages has been bought inside. All that are the innovations. So that is what entirely new product that leads to new opportunities. So this third category, you can take an example of a mobile phone, computer systems, where each day programming languages are changing and they are updating and entirely a new things come out, emerges in the field of computers, in the field of mobile phones, in the field of iPads, everything, where this, it falls under the category 3. Next is category 4, where you have old products, old process used in a new way. So everything is old, but the usage of the product is entirely new. So this is the 4 categories you can imagine and you can see where you can fit it. But the second category is fully out of focus, where there will be no innovation itself. Whatever is happening, that will be there. Whereas in the other 3 categories, you can choose where I fit in. So what type of ideas I have? Will I choose if I have a so problem is old, but I have new solutions for it? Then you try to identify. So the problem exists. Let me give an example. There are a lot of pet lovers. So most of the families, at least one people in the family will be a pet lover. But all the families will not allow the persons to have their pets with them. So there are many families who hesitate to have the pets. So we will be not able to take up the... So this problem has existing. So in Bangalore, there is a company which came up with a solution for this problem. Because ellar veetliye or nayo puniyo valakkanum nu irpo and the manasu and the asa vandha nama manasukulliye irkum that will be there in our mind, but a father, mother or some grandparents, they will not allow. So this problem was existing for more than 10 years or 12 years. There is a company in Bangalore who came up with a solution where you have a pet park. It is called as a pet park, where they have all pet animals. So in that pet park, they have all pet animals and birds. So whatever pets that has been accepted or kept in the house as a pet, all the animals, you can find it in that particular park. So you, if you are interested, you can just go pay them and spend for 1 hour, half a day or in weekends, and you can enjoy with the pets and you can come back. The only thing is you cannot take the pets with you to the home. But so see, the problem is old, but they have found out a new solution where the pet lovers, they can go spend whichever pet you're interested. If you're interested with dog, then you can. And they have varieties of dogs also. Whichever dogs you are, just by pay, they charge. It per charges varies for 1 hour, half a day, full day, 2 days. So it depends upon the customer choice. You can just pay and you can spend your time with your pet animals. So this is the category one. The problem exists. So you find solutions for that. When it comes to the new, the here what we can say that the category three is the food delivery platform. It is entirely a new concept where they have come up with new ideas and it has opened up for new opportunities. So the restaurants, imagine this Swiggy, Zomato food delivery platforms, they have opened up with a new opportunity, job opportunities, and the restaurants are able to sell their foods. There are a lot of small restaurants which is not able to reach out the entire customers. Swiggy and Zomato has helped them to reach out, because when you open Swiggy or Zomato menu card, there we can see, for example, we doesn't know what are the various restaurants that is available in Erode. But when you open the Swiggy or a Zomato app, you can see the n number of restaurants who are specialized with a particular type of foods. So this is what is the third category. So one platform, one innovative idea is opening up a way to n number of new opportunities. So Swiggy is benefiting, and the same way the other restaurants in and around Erode is benefiting, and you provide employment opportunities to n number of people by appointing them as a delivery voice. This is what is, we call it as category three. So one idea open up for the entirely a innovative idea for a entirely new opportunities for n number of businesses. This category four, old product or old process used in a new way. So it is a old product, but you try to identify new usage for the products. So here you can take examples of FMCG products where they try to see a cosmetics, for example, face work, soap. Now you have, it is a old product, but the way it in a new way they try to use the soap. It has been first, normally we use soaps to refresh ourselves. The same soap was modified into a liquid form where it is a, where you can have as a face wash. So this is the category four, where the product is old, but you try to identify new usage for the product. So the innovations can also be of these categories. Coming up to creativity. So what does creativity say? How, as I said in the first slide, creativity is from your head, whereas innovation is from your world. So as I said in the previous slide, innovation. So whatever I discussed in all these categories, everything happens in the world. Whereas when it comes to creativity, creativity comes from the individual head, individual brain. Creativity is the individual brain. It is your brain. So how you can view the creativity? There are two ways you can go with your creativity. One is, do not wait for opportunity, create it. It is the wording from APJ Abdul Kalam sir. So never ever the opportunity knocks your door. You have to create it. As I said, in this competitive world, each minute everything is getting outdated. Everything is getting advanced. So there are n number of opportunities that is available in this world. But the opportunities will never come and knock the door. You have to create an opportunity. So how you can create opportunity? You have to think. You have to think. That is why I'll say how I can think. Train your brain. Your brain can be trained. That is what I say to most of my students. See, you can train your brain by small, small exercises, small, small things. You can train your brain, and once you train your brain, automatically n number of ideas will pump up in your brain. So you try to create ideas. So how I can create opportunity? How I can create up? Again, I'll give you an example. See, lot of people, most of the house, now you can see both the genders are working, husband and wife, they are working. And nowadays, as we know that everyone is merged into a single nuclear family system where husband, wife and the children. So this is the family setup that has been emerging in India, which is demanding for n number of business opportunities. So this nuclear family system, since both are working, they doesn't have time to maintain their house. They doesn't have time to take care of their pets, but they want their pets at home. And they doesn't have time to clean their own vehicles, that is their own car, their own two-wheelers, which they use daily. So these three areas, they have identified a business and they are running successfully. For example, first I said that since they both are working, they doesn't have time to maintain their house. There are a lot of small startups who are there to come to your house at the weekend and clean throughout your house. They will clean your bathrooms, they will clean your entire house, mop it, dust it, and they take just 1 or 2 hours. They do everything, place everything at their respective place. They charge you and they will walk out. Look at the idea. See from where? So they have created. So the problem is there. For that problem, you try to create an opportunity. And again, see, I want a pet. I want my dog to lie down near me when I enjoy watching TV. I want to sleep with my dog. But I doesn't have time to take it out for a walk. In Coimbatore, there is a company where they rent the persons, where there are persons who go to the places wherever they need the pets to be taken for a walk. By 5:30, they go knock the doors, they take the pet for a walk, and all the morning things are done outside. They bring back and they leave. Just for 1 hour, they are charging 1,000 rupees. So just imagine, they might have never thought of this idea. Again, as I said, the third thing is they use vehicles, they use cars to travel, they use two-wheelers to travel, but they don't have time to clean it. Again, in all the metropolitan cities, there are persons available who comes and cleans your car and charges an amount. If you want it, daily they'll come and clean. So they'll come, if you can just fix a time, they come by that time, they just come. Wash your car, wipe the car. If it is a two-wheeler, do what? Charge and they'll go. So this is where you can create. We know these are the problems that is available. You try to create. The next view of creativity is identify. So you identify what is the problem. So sit and analyze. So what is the problem the people are facing? And you identify the problems and you try to bring a solution. There is, again, I'll give you an example. There is a company in Bangalore where they, like a courier service, they work. They are ready to pick anything from one place to another place. To be very simple, let me say, most of the married girls, what they try is, they used to transit all items from mother's place to their place. this is what will happen. So they have identified. So there are, so they see, as I said, everyone is working. We never have time to carry these things from one place to another, whether it may be from mother's place to their place, or from their place to their mother-in-law's place, or from their place to their relative place. They don't have time. But so these companies, what they do is they are ready to pick the items, whether it is a slippers, food items, snack items, or even the dinner, breakfast, whatever you want to give to your father's place or to your relative place, they're ready to pick the items from one place to another and deliver, and they get a charge for that. So you just identify for in your place what is the problem the persons are placing. So can I give solution for that particular problem? Can I convert that solution into a business concept? So this is how the creativity you can develop, and that creativity can be converted into ideas, that ideas can be implemented as business concepts, and then you can take out the impact, that is the money revenue you can generate. So these are the two ways through which you can view the creativity. One is, don't wait for the opportunity, you try to create opportunity. The second one is, you try to identify solutions for the problems that exist in the society. It may be, it looks very foolish or very simple, but that may bring in a huge revenue for you when it is, when that idea is converted into business model and it is implemented as a commercial model. So what are the ways by which I can enhance my creativity? So I was talking, so it is the creativity which leads to innovation. So you people have to be creative. Unless otherwise you're creative, you cannot start and run a business. Then the question arises, how I can be creative? So what are the ways through which I can enhance my personal creativity? So here I have seven points which may help you to improve your personal creativity. So once you are able to enhance your personal creativity, automatically you will get n number of ideas where then you can implement that ideas accordingly. So the first thing is, accept there is no right answer. Do not follow the rules. Be foolish. Ask what if. Think outside your area. Go to ambiguity. Believe in yourself. So let us see one by one. Accept there is no right answer. See, what is this? Accept there is no right answer. So as I said, for all questions, you will have a number of answers. That is a known solution. So for one problem, if there is a problem, damn sure there will be a solution for the problem. If there is a question, damn sure there will be an answer. But can you give right answers for all the questions? Is it possible for us to give right answers to all the questions? No, it is not. So you have to accept there is no right answer. This means that each problem have a solution, and you cannot say that all the solutions that is given for the problem will be right. And there is no, so you can again try to give a better answer. If there is no right answer, it means that there has been no better solution. So this answer can be improvised. This thing can be improvised, and you can give better answer for the no right answer. So you have to accept it. You have to work on it, and fine-tune, and find a solution. Don't stop at the initial stage. An idea may be there. You try to fine-tune that idea, linking all your societal factors. then you come out with a solution. Do not follow the rules. See, let me be very frank. It doesn't mean that you always you have to violate the rules. It is not that way. See, there are certain rules which we should follow. There are certain rules where just by violating the rules, nothing wrong will happen. Please try to understand. By violating that some rules, nothing wrong will happen. Some benefits we will enjoy. That is what we talk about. Do not follow the rules. So since when we are creative, there are situations which demands you to break the rules. So that time, it is not wrong to break the rules. That is what I want to insist here. So being a creative person, to improvise your creativity, see to it, you do not follow rules. So if the situation demands, then there is nothing wrong in breaking the rules. Be foolish. So as I said, when I was reading the article that was related to taking a pet dog for a walk, you know, I'm கொலோக்கியலாக நம்மளோட இதில் சொல்லணும் அப்படின்னா, நம்ம ஒரு பெட்ட அனிமல் வளர்த்திருக்கோம் அப்படின்னா அதை வெளியே கூட்டிட்டு போய் சுவிட்சாக போக வைக்கிறதுக்கு கூட நம்மளுக்கு டைம் இல்லை அப்படிங்கிறப்ப வி வில் ஹாவ் வை ஷுட் இட் மே லுக் அஃப் அஸ் ஃபூலிஷ் பட் சி தட் ஹாஸ் கிவன் அ என் அ பிக் பிஸ்னஸ் டு அ பர்சன் பீங் ஹி பிகாஸ் வென் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டைம் வென் யூ ஹியர் தீஸ் டைப் ஆஃப் திங்ஸ் வி திங்க் என் Why is it he fooled to go with this idea? Even the friend circles, they will tell you, are you foolish to, is this is an idea? Is it possible for you to implement this business idea? Don't it look foolish? But that will be the starting point for your business. That is what is happening. So there is nothing wrong being foolish. You be foolish, but see to it, all the foolish ideas cannot be commercialized. That also you have to have it in mind. So you can be foolish. That foolish ideas should gain you something good. Ask what if. So here you just ask a question. What if what will happen if I do this? If I doesn't do it, what will happen? So you just repeat what if questions within you, where you can find out a number of answers for what if. That gives you a lot of ideas can be generated. Then you can filter those ideas and you can come up. So there is nothing wrong in asking what if, because you can see in movies and other things, what if. So this what if repetitions will give you more ideas for you, more inputs for you. Think outside your area. So that is what normally we say as an entrepreneur or any business people, you should think outside your out of box thinking. So you think outside. So don't go with usual answers. Don't go with usual suggestions, usual discussion. Try to think outside the area. What is impossible will be possible. What is impossible will be possible if we sit and work. If you're really determined, then surely that will work out. So you just think outside your area and think. So whoever has said this is not possible, take that not possible ideas and you try to make it possible. That is what we say. Think outside your area. Go to ambiguity. Again, see. go to ambiguity. That is nothing but ambiguity is the quality of being open to more than one interpretation. So you a one word can be interpreted into two or three meanings. So you just interpret the ideas. So this that is why again go to ambiguity is ask what if. So if this is the solution, what happens? If this is the solution, what happens? So getting more number of interpretation for the same idea. The last one is believe in yourself. So for you believe in yourself, you should have a confidence that I can do it. I will do it. So that is what we say, believe in yourself. You believe that I can do it. It will be possible. I can overcome. So that is, I can make the impossible possible by my work. So you believe yourself that I can do, I will do, and I can achieve anything. And we can achieve anything if we are passionate and if we are dedicated and committed to the work in which you're dealing with. So as a businessman, you should have that commitment and dedication so that you can do whatever you like and you believe that it will be possible by you to do the certain things. So before winding up, I just want to share with you these startup equations. So what all I discussed with you till now, it forms as a equation, and this is the successful startup equations which will help you to run your business more successfully. So new business, so whatever idea, as I said, the first I of innovation, so your idea has been converted into a new business. With that new business, if you're innovative enough, if your innovation, you have entirely a new idea which you're going to commercialize, add with that the technology, but add with that your patience. That is what is startups. I'll give you an example of a Swiggy. When you just go and Google the word Swiggy, you can see that the founder is from Bits Bilani, and he loves traveling towards many countries, and he has traveled and he has acquired lot of cushions from the various places, and there are untold stories of Swiggy, where this again the new business of online platform thing is, they were three friends who were in Delhi. They were fond of eating foods. They were very fond of eating foods. So they used to go search of restaurants where they give different items, and they used to taste. One day they got bored and they were tired. I can put a word tired. They were very tired of searching of foods, and they were sitting and talking. Why can't, if there is one place where we can go eat or taste all the cushions, and is it possible? And since they are very much interested in foods, they started collecting the menu cards. And so this has made them, they had their own database about the various restaurants throughout Delhi, and all the menu cards of the restaurants was available with them. So they started an idea, why can't we develop a business with this? So since we have all the restaurants' addresses, contact numbers, contact details with us, and at the same time we have the menu cards of all the restaurants with us. So with this data, is it possible for us to establish a new business? Yes, there came a new business idea. So sitting at home, how we can order? Then, so innovation. See, they started to innovate. So I have the restaurants list. I have the menu cards of all the restaurants. Is it possible for me to sit at home and order the food. So what is the way? They searched. There came the technology. The technology helped them. Yes, with the help of technology, I can. So they tried to develop an app. So they developed an app and they uploaded everything for various restaurants. List in the app, the menu cards of various restaurants. They just segregated veg, non-veg and all cushions, whichever cushions are available in the various restaurants. There came innovation. At last, I've said it is a passion. Since these guys are more fond of foods, they were passionate to eat. That passion made them to be innovative. When they added the technology with the innovation, they were able to come up with the new startups. So this is how the business ideas comes. So I can surely say that without the combination of all the four, startup success is not possible. If you have business, if you have innovation, if you have technology, there is no patience. After a short period of time, you will not be, unless otherwise you're passionate towards a particular thing, that will be a triggering point that will push you towards the success of the business. So in this four, new business, innovation, technology, if even one is missing, you cannot be a successful business. See, all the four has to be combined together. If all these four equations are added, are shared in equal proportions, you can come up with a successful startup and you can succeed in your business travel. So I hope we can end up the session. If you have any questions or anything, you can put it in the chat box. Otherwise, I can wind up. Thank you, students. And I take an opportunity to thank our management, IIC coordinator, Jayanti ma'am, and the BCA department, the head of the department, Sangeeta ma'am, for giving me such a wonderful opportunity to share my thoughts with your students. Thank you.